I don't think the disgruntled Hillary supporters would be big on Bob Barr.
Really?
Probably not.
You misunderestimate your mustache, sir.
No. You pointed that out last time.
Well, welcome back to the Most Politics in the Morning. That was Bob Barr taking some ribbing from Stephen Colbert. The Libertarian candidate for president has been closely watching the Democratic convention, and he joins me now. Thanks for being with us.
A pleasure, as always.
You know, you said to Stephen Colbert that disgruntled Hillary supporters might not actually be looking to vote for Bob Barr. But we have a research poll out today that's very interesting. It shows 27%, more than a quarter of Hillary Clinton supporters, say they'd rather vote for John McCain than Barack Obama. What can you offer them if they're looking to take their vote elsewhere?
Well, of course, what we can offer them is a whole new approach, something very different, of course, from the policies of the Bush administration, which will continue under McCain if he were elected. That's appealing to both sides, both disgruntled, disenfranchised, disenchanted Republicans, as well as disenchanted, disenfranchised Democrats. Both sides want something new, something different, something positive. And they want to heal the, there are very deep rifts in both parties. It's not just the Democrats that are having this problem right now.
What did you think of her speech last night? Did she succeed in helping unify the Democrats behind Barack Obama?
I don't think so. I mean, and that's not to take anything away from her speech. I mean, there's only so much you can do. People know that there are very, very deep feelings there on the part of Hillary Clinton. She said what she had to say. And Bill Clinton, when he gives his speech, I mean, he'll say what he has to say. But there's a lot more to it than just giving a speech. The speechifying ends in a couple of days, and then the really hard work begins.
Yeah, and it's interesting because there is a new CNN poll out as well this morning that shows when you talk about the issues, John McCain and Obama are really neck and neck on the issue of solving the country's problems. There are 17% in this poll, though, who say they don't believe either one can do the job. Should that 17% vote for you, how are you showing them that you would be the one who could help solve some of our biggest problems?
Actually, we're the only, I'm the only candidate among all three of us that's put together, for example, and put out there a comprehensive, specific plan on saving Social Security. The other candidates don't want to touch it. They almost recoil from dealing with such major problems. We're the only campaign that has put out a program for significantly cutting federal spending.
How do you do all that? How do we, gracefully get out of Iraq and continue to fund things like Social Security and balance the budget?
Of course, getting out of Iraq,
without raising taxes,
getting out of Iraq will free up about $400 million a day that can go back to the American people.
All right. Well, it was great talking to you. Thanks for being with us.
Pleasure as always.
Bob Barr, everyone. Thanks.